everyone, welcome back to my channel and thank you guys so much for watching. So today's look is on this look that I have on my face right now, and I've been wanting to do an emerald type of look for a very long time. I think this is the perfect look for now Christmas time or any holiday parties that you have to attend. A lot of office jobs, they host kind of like a Christmas dinner. At least I know I have a Christmas dinner to attend to, and yeah, this is a look that I would wear because it's very glamorous but it's not too in your face, and it's very festive because since it is kind of like an emerald type of look, it's very festive with the green, so the green kind of matches the theme of Christmas. And yeah, I hope that you guys enjoy this video. I know that I said that I was going to have the giveaway winners be announced in this video, but I did not know I had over 300 comments, so I did already start looking through them and I wasn't able to finish looking at all of them for this video. But don't worry, because Friday I should be done and I will be posting another video on Friday. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you guys enjoy this video, and until next time, I will see you guys later. Bye. Okay guys, so I had no idea my camera wasn't recording, but pretty much all I did was prime my eyelids, and then I took Shadow by MAC and I put this all over the crease to serve as a transition shade. And Shadow is just a really pretty warm brown, so any warm brown will work. The next color that I'm taking is this deep emerald color. I don't have the name with me, but I will leave it linked down below. And pretty much I am just putting this in the inner and outer corners, and then I'm going to be connecting it together through the crease. I've done this technique a million of times here on my channel. Well, maybe not a million of times, but you guys get what I mean. I've done this a bunch of times, and it is by far one of my favorite techniques because it makes the eye look very pretty and it looks the eye very round, and I just love it. So once I have that in the inner and outer corners as well as connected through in the crease, I'm going to take a very fluffy brush, but a brush that's still tapered. So this is the Sigma E35, I believe. And pretty much all I'm going to do is blend out those edges and make sure that everything is smooth. I did it very sloppy at first. I pretty much was just mapping it out, and once I was done mapping all of it out, I took that brush and just kind of smoothed those edges, and just to make sure that everything blends. And this is why Shadow is so important, because this is the type of color that's going to make those colors kind of just blend together. I went back in with that E40 with no extra Shadow and blended it further, and also wiped off any excess. So now for the center of this look, which is by far my favorite part of the whole entire look, I am taking Maui Wowie by Urban Decay. And I love this color. I love this color as a highlight. I love this color as a brow bone highlight. I love this color all over the lid. Or I also love it as a pop of color, like, oh, not a pop of color, but it's kind of like an accent like I'm doing in this tutorial. So I pretty much popped that all over in the center of the lid. I'm so sorry. I popped it in the center of the lid, and then I took a Sigma E25 with a little bit more of that olive green and just intensified the inner and outer corners. And then I took that E40 once more and I blended out those edges. So now I'm taking that same brush, mixing it with some Fix Plus, and I'm going back in with that Maui Wowie, and pretty much I am just intensifying that color. And the Fix Plus is awesome because it brings out the pigments and it just makes it look very metallic, which I love. And then I go back in with that E35 to blend it out further and intensify it further. So yeah, I love doing this. So I applied some mascara as well as some false lashes, and then onto primer. I'm taking my Smashbox Pore Finish or Pore Minimizing Primer, and I'm applying it all over my face. And then for foundation, I am using the Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. I'm taking it with my Tarte Airbrush, Flawless Airbrush, Finish foundation brush. I believe that's the name. I actually featured this brush in my favorites, which is my last video, so go ahead and check it out to hear some awesomeness about this brush, because I talked about it way too much, I believe. So I am just putting this all over my skin, and I absolutely love this foundation because it gives me a very glowy look to the skin, which I love for the winter months. So to conceal, take your favorite concealer. I am taking my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NC20 and I'm applying it under the eyes. And lately I've been using less concealer and I love the way it looks. It actually looks a little bit better. I took it with the damp with a damp beauty blender just to blend it out. And if you guys notice, I didn't take this concealer up to kind of the lower lash line. I kind of left the lower lash line blank because I feel like it actually avoids creasing. So I've been trying that out and I like it so far. I'm taking the Anastasia Banana Powder to set the under eye area, and I also put it a little bit on my T-zone just to set everything in place. Go ahead and do your brows. I'm using the Anastasia Brow Wiz, and then I'm going to set it with the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. For contour, I am taking my matte bronzer by Tarte, and this one is in Park Avenue Princess, but this one is the one in the matte shade because I believe they have one that has a little bit of shimmer. But since I have so much going on in the eyes, I wanted to keep the face, or at least the contour and blush, pretty matte. So I'm taking it with a MAC 109 brush, which has been my favorite to apply contour lately or bronzer. For blush, I am taking this one by NARS, and I feel so bad because I should know the name of this blush. I believe this one's Sin. I love it, and it's awesome. And here's my face because the camera was making it look like I had applied way too much, but now looking back at the footage, I feel like it looks okay. So that's funny, but anyways, for highlights, I am taking my Becca Opal. You want to take something that has a gold undertone, and this one is perfect for that. So apply that to the cheekbones, and I also took it down my nose as well as the bridge of my lips. Not the bridge of my lips, the Cupid's bow, and down the bridge of my nose. There you go. I also took that same opal and applied it to my brow bone, and then I took that mossy type of green and I applied this to my waterline. I took a little bit of more shadow and I blended the heck out of my under eye area because I really, really wanted to smoke it out and kind of make that green pop with the brown. So this part is optional. You don't have to do it, but I decided to do it just to kind of smoke out the eye a little bit more. But all I did was line my waterline with a black pencil. So I lined my lips with MAC's Strip Down Lip Pencil and I overlined them just a bit. I topped it off with Angel, also by MAC, which is my favorite nude at the moment. And then I topped it off with Underage Lip Gloss, also by MAC. And once you have done that, you are pretty much done. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys. And until next time, I will see you guys later. Bye.